Webco, or Webco followers, I should say. Sorry we were a little bit late getting started on the Alumni Cabaret. I was having some technical difficulties. I think my fat fingers just could not figure out how to type in the password to get into the account. So, you know, hi Trace, how's it going? Amy Eernissee must be Eden Eernissee's mother. Webco, yes. Sophie, hi. Hi, everyone. Oh, hi, Sarah Harmon and Linda. Stop it, Lara. We're just here. We're here to be fabulous and have a good time. It's going to be great. Molly, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Oh, this is so exciting. I'm so excited, you guys. How fun. Some of you are, if you're alum, like relatively recent alum, so I graduated in 2019, so not that long ago, a little over a year ago, and some of the like more recent, if you will, alum, I probably know your names, so if I see them scroll across here and I'm like, oh you, and you're like, I don't know who that is, it's because you have a, you know, you're famous in the Webco world. Hi, Kara. Oh, hello. Hi, Cecily. Hello, hello. This is so exciting. I love seeing the little names pop up at the bottom here. Hi, Benny B. Benny B. Love. Oh, Jeremy, cute, fun. How fun. This is great. Hello. Hello, hello. Amazing. Okay, so, sorry, I'm looking at, if you notice me looking down, it's because I'm looking at my notes, because I'm trying to, love you too, Ben. I'm trying to make sure that I'm doing things correctly, because I would not say that I am technologically challenged. I would just say that it's not necessarily my thing. I'm one of those people age-wise that's right on the cusp of being a Gen Z and a millennial, and I definitely am more towards the millennial side. I'm just not as tech savvy. Beth Strobel's here. Woohoo! Will Lara, Kara's asking a real question here. Will Lara Teeter be performing Tabata for us? Lara, you let me know, all right? Okay, so, but anyway, I'm not necessarily like technically challenged, but I just have a hard time sometimes. So I'm trying to like kind of get everything together and make sure I dot my I's and cross my T's, if you know what I'm saying. So, yeah, okay, so I guess I'll just go ahead and get the ball rolling then. My name is Lauren Louise. For those of you that have just joined us, and for those of you that have been here since I started this, or I didn't start like this, but since I started the live stream. Anyway, I'm Lauren Louise. I am a 2019 acting major graduate from the BFA program at Webster University. Which we all affectionately know as Webco. And I, a while back, some of the current students in the conservatory put out a blast on the alumni pages and were like, hey, we have been doing this amazing thing called the LokDown Cabarets, where lock with the L-O-K, Gorlocks, what's up, baby? They've been doing this thing called LokDown Cabaret, where they have current students join in and sing, and it's a really cool virtual cabaret that's done over Instagram Live. Super innovative, super fun, and really like easy and, well, not easy, but great way to bring a smile to people's faces at this time. And anyway, they put out a blast and were like, hey, we want to do an alumni show. And I was immediately like, oh my God, yes, I would love to participate. And can I host? Because that's just the kind of person I am. And they were like, yes, you can host. And I was like, amazing, sign me up. So here we are. And we are going to have we have an awesome lineup for you guys tonight of alumni, who you'll get to know throughout the evening. It's gonna be a lot of fun. I will stop rambling now so we can actually get to the singing. Yeah, so we'll wait for them to join us, but first we're gonna have Galen Crawley, who is an MT from 2010. Hi, Ted Luthin. So Ted Luthin, Vivienne Luthin, one of our performers and one of my classmates' dad, just commented and said, Bucky for the win. So I have a wiener dog. I have three wiener dogs, but one of them is named Bucky. And he's kind of an honorary class member for my class, if I may be so presumptuous to say that. And so he's upstairs. He's not watching, unfortunately, but my dog, Olive, is actually over here. She's playing with a chew toy while we do this. So we want Bucky. It's storming outside, so he's pretty upset, but maybe Olive will make an appearance later. Okay. So Galen is joining us. Galen Crawley is going to join us and we're going to hear her sing and it's going to be wonderful. And like I said, she is an MT, so musical theater major from 2010. Hey, Galen.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm wonderful. It's been a lovely evening.
Yes. Fighting with technology, always exciting.
Oh, yeah. So where are you joining us from?
At the moment, I am in a basement in Clarksville, Tennessee. My husband, I'm sorry?
Incredible.
My husband and I had, we've been living in Atlanta for about 10 years. We moved to New York in February, the perfect time to move to New York, because then in March, we had to leave. So now we're staying with friends in Tennessee.
Nice. Well, I feel you. I moved to New York for the first time. I was like, here I go. It was like that scene from Annie where she shows up with her little bags and everything. And I was like, okay.
Yeah.
Yep. I showed up in December, beginning of December, and shortly left after.
Yeah. So,
you know, but we're glad that you're safe and you're happy and you're in a basement going to sing some songs for us. So yay.
Exactly.
Amazing. So what are you singing for us?
I'm going to be singing When He Sees Me from Waitress. This is a song that I had been a little, I would say, disconnected from like the Broadway scene for a while. I just was living in Atlanta and hadn't really been paying attention to what was going on in New York and was getting kind of down about theater. And I went on a trip, and while I was visiting New York, I listened to this cast recording. And as soon as I heard this song, it like reignited my love for musical theater all over again. And I would say that it's one of the things that gave me the kick to get me thinking about moving to New York and about really kind of screwing my head on in a different way, thinking about this business. So it's a song I've wanted to sing for a long time and I'm excited to share it.
That's awesome. Well, great. Whenever you're ready to share it with us, we are ready to hear it.
I stick with real things, usually facts and figures. When information's in its place, I minimize the guessing game. Guess what? I don't like guessing games, or when I feel things before I know the feelings. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate on an unexpected date with a stranger whom I talk too fast, or ask me questions about myself before I've decided that he can ask me questions about myself? He might sit too close, or call the waiter by his first name, or eat Oreos, but eat the cookie before the cream. But what scares me the most, what scares me the most, is what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like me, what if he runs the other way and I can't hide from him? What happens then if when I give myself away to only get it given back? I could live with that. So I'm just fine inside my shell, shaped mind. This way I get the best view, so that when he sees me, I want him to. I'm not defensive. I'm simply being cautious. I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating. Why? A certain suitor stands in line. I've seen in movies, most made for television. You cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable life. girls, but he could be criminal. Some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. He could be colorblind. How untrustworthy is that? He could be less than blind. Or even worse, he could be very nice and have lovely eyes and make me laugh. Come out of fire. What do I do with that? God, what if when he sees me, I like him and he knows it? What if he opens up a door and I can't close it? What happens then if when he holds me, my heart is set in motion? I'm not prepared for that. I'm scared to break it open. But still I to talk to who lights the way I am. Someone who, when he sees me, wants to again.
Bravo! Yay!
Everybody watching.
That was awesome. I love the line of what is it about the pearls, somewhere where they don't have pearls or something.
I think oh. Girls, somewhere where they don't have girls.
Oh, where they don't have girls.
Look out. Oh. Look out. They don't know how to treat a lady.
No. I love it. That's awesome. Waitress is one of the shows that I have not seen yet, and I've had very little exposure to. Like, I've had clips of it, of different songs and stuff played for me or sung, you know, to around me, and it's really cool music, so I do want to get to see it.
It's wonderful. I got to see it I guess in 2018 I saw one of Jesse Mueller's last performances. She was incredible. The whole show is incredible. I mean, it's Sara Bareilles music. How can you go wrong?
True. Sara Bareilles, I feel like, was my entire like middle school life. I was like, I for the talent show, I think I sung a Sara Bareilles song, and I was like, I am her. So
that
great.
So you think you can dance routine to Gravity?
Yes.
That was like a formative experience for people my age. I would say it's a generational moment.
Oh my gosh. Yes. Incredible. Thank you so much for joining us, Galen.
Thank you.
Amazing. Fun fact about Galen, she is a black belt. I don't know what in, but a black belt. I guess in karate, taekwondo, something. But that's awesome, because I know it takes a really long time and a lot of work to get to a black belt. So that's amazing. Yeah, like I said, Waitress is one of those shows that I've heard so much of, and I've like bits and pieces, and I haven't like actually gotten to see it or really explore like what it's about, but it's absolutely beautiful music. One of our other performers and one of my classmates, Caitlin Witty, she sang a piece from Waitress for Senior Showcase last year, which was really, really wonderful and really special. So, yeah, I'm trying to look and see who our next person is. But, okay, so our next person is Michael Williams. Michael Williams is going to join us. I guess I could, like, switch to his little page. There we go. There we go. We're learning, folks. Thanks for being so patient with me, everyone. I know this is, it's so much easier to watch these things than it is to do them. I promise you. Also, if you are hearing any kind of like rumbling noises in the background, unfortunately, so I'm quarantining at home with my parents in Cincinnati, Ohio. And it is raining really hard right now. And there's like a major thunderstorm that's supposed to be heading this way. So if you hear rumbling in the background or anything, that's what it is. It's thundering. We also have dogs upstairs that don't like the rain. So hopefully that won't be a problem and we can just roll right along. But if not, you know, we're all learning. We're all doing this together. Thanks for being here with us. It's going to be super fun. So we're having a little bit of a technical difficulty. Oh, nope, here we go. So Michael Williams is going to be joining us. He was an MT, graduated in 2015. Oh my gosh, Sophie, there's a tornado watch in Northern Illinois too. Wow, that's crazy. Okay, well, I thought I saw, here it is. Here we go. Okay, so Michael Williams is going to join us here for a second. Oh, thanks, Lara. Hi, oh, wow. Michael.
I panicked for a second. I'm glad it worked out.
I was having trouble logging on at the beginning. So like for the first like 4 minutes past 8:30 here, I was like, oh my God, the world is ending. I can't log on.
What am I gonna do?
So my heart like was pounding in my chest and I was like, oh my God, this is the end of it all.
Still is. Still yeah. is for me.
Amazing. Well, welcome. Welcome to our virtual cabaret lounge.
An honor and a pleasure to be here. Webco 15.
Yes. So tell us a little bit about you. Where are you right now? Where are you from? What, you know, the basics.
Right, the basics. I'm the Pisces. Webco class of 2015 with the MT class, three people, living strong, lots of class time. When all this went down, I flew back to Texas. So I'm currently home in my childhood bedroom in Houston, Texas.
Yes, but I've been sleeping in my childhood bedroom too, and it's like
the best.
It's a warm hug. Honestly, kind of great.
I agree.
Awesome, amazing. Well, what are you going to be singing for us?
I'm going to be singing an original composition on this little instrument right here. It's called Come Around. It's about the different speeds at which people fall in love.
Nice. That's awesome. Okay, yeah. Well, whenever you're ready.
Thanks so much.
Come
come around.
Beautiful. I love that. That was awesome. I also think it's so cool that you played on created this piece on ukulele, because I feel like ukulele is such an underappreciated instrument.
It truly is. Yeah. I stand before you today as a champion for the underratedness of the ukulele, for sure.
And that is just so beautiful. I mean, it's cool. The ukulele can be so much more than just like this, you know, like campy little sing-along thing. It's an actual instrument, which is beautiful.
I like to think so. Thank you, darling.
Well, great job. Wonderful work. Amazing. So you submitted a little fun fact about yourself, and you said you broke your nose on the back of a love seat after doing when you were doing a magic trick. I need to know some more about that.
I can help you out there. Around fifth grade, I had the great idea to put a blanket over my head, which was my first mistake, and jump up from underneath it, but tuck down fast enough to where it would look like the blanket was floating and I was not in it anymore, you know, like a cartoon and not real life. So I was practicing around my living room, as you do. And after a couple of good attempts, very Jeff Awada style, like exploring it till it can't be explored anymore, I realized that I wasn't getting enough tuck so that, you know, the blanket would look like it was floating. So I got right back behind my love seat, curled back, and then tucked down really quickly and jammed like the very bridge of my nose against the back of my love seat, bounced like right off, and then wash of pain.
Oh, man.
That's the story. And I learned that day that, that I need to work even harder on magic, and that, you know, there's room for grace in all things.
Yeah, or that you need to do it in like a completely empty room.
Yes, I should have been doing it in the spaces with all the mats. That's what it would have been better that way.
That was your first mistake, is not being a web coat when you were in fifth grade.
Fifth grade year old me.
Incredible. Well, it was so awesome to have you here, and we loved your piece. So thanks for sharing with us.
Thanks for having me. It was great. And break legs to all the other folks we're going to see tonight. So cool to rep Webco today. Appreciate the opportunity.
That's been awesome. All right. Well, we'll see you.
Cheers.
Oh, so fun. Okay. The best part about this, y'all, is the fact that, like, I have gotten to meet these people. So some of these people went to school with me at the same time. like our next guest, who is going to be Madeline Purches. And she and I went to school at the same time, so we were both at Webco together, but Michael Williams graduated the year before I got there, so I heard, you know, his name in the hallway, and I knew who he was through hearsay, but I had never gotten to meet him, and it's pretty cool to, like, have this opportunity to, like, get to know each other, even if it's just during a brief sound check and a virtual cabaret. It's been really, really fun and a really cool opportunity. I think, you know, that's something that we do a lot when we're at the showcases in New York and LA. We have, like, receptions for alumni, and, you know, the New York showcase this year was at just about the same time that, like, COVID kind of started being on the forefront of people's minds, and, like, we actually started to be worried about it. And so I think there was definitely, like, you know, an effect on how we interacted with each other at that time. So it's really cool to get to see everyone and hang out with everyone and here and now at this really cool moment. So, oh yes, it's lovely. What's I'm reading these comments, and it's very funny. There's lots of things going on here. Okay, so anyway, Madeline Purches is going to join us. She was an MT from 2017. And here she is. She's going to join us here in a second. Let's get that connection going.
Hello.
Hey, how are you?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm great.
That's good. Yes. Oh my gosh. Congrats on getting over the technical difficulties. We were all reading it for you.
Thank you. It was a struggle for a minute. I think I just had really fat thumbs and I couldn't get the letters right or something. I don't know.
But you made it. You made it. And we're here.
Yeah. We're here. Amazing. So, okay. Where are you from? Where are you currently? How's quarantine treating you? Have you baked banana bread lately?
Have I baked it? Well, okay, so I'm from Texas. I am currently in New York City. You know, there was that period of time where it was like, am I going to leave? Am I going to stay? And I just stayed. And now it's like, I'm not going to leave at this point. So I've been here the whole time. It's been, you know what, though, as much as I've been in my apartment, I could have been anywhere in the world. I've not baked banana bread, but I have baked a whole bunch of some of my family's here. I've baked a whole bunch of cookies that we in our family call Grandma's Nuggets. They're like a family recipe. I've baked those like 6 times. So I've done a lot of baking, just not banana bread.
Nice. Nice. Yeah. I know everyone is baking like banana breads and sourdoughs and stuff like that. I went to the grocery store the other day because my dad, like before all this started, he makes a lot of bread. He enjoys doing it, and I went to the store and he was like, oh, can you pick up some packets of yeast? And I like reached on the shelf and there was nothing.
It's nowhere. Absolutely nowhere.
And
you can't
I
get
was
it.
Shocked mm-hmm. because I was like, who uses yeast? Nobody makes their own bread.
What We've got nothing happening? Else to do.
I know. It's great. It's pretty cool. I mean, I get it. I get it. I'm all for making your loaf of bread when you got the time, but it was just hilarious. All right. So what are you going to sing for us?
I'm going to be singing Everybody Loves Louie from Sunday in the Park with George.
Yes. Amazing. All right. Well, whenever you're ready.
Great. Thank you, ma'am. Oh, no. Oh, goodness. Well, you're not the only one with technical difficulties. Hello, George. Where did you go, George? I know you're near, George. I caught your eye, George. I want your ear, George. I've a surprise, George. Everybody loves Louie. Louie's simple and kind. Everybody loves Louie. Louie's lovable. Seems we never know, do we, who we're going to find. And Louie the baker. Not what I had in mind. But Louie's really an artist. Louie's cakes are an art. Louie isn't the smartest. Louie's popular. Everybody loves Louie. Louie makes from the heart. The bread, George. I mean the bread, George. And then in bed, George. I mean he needs me. I mean like don't George. Hello, George. Louis always so pleasant. Louis always so fair. Louis makes you feel present. Louis generous. That's the thing about Louis. Louis always is there. Louis' thoughts are not hard to follow. Louis' art is not hard to swallow. Not that Louis' perfection, that's what makes him ideal. Hardly anything worth objection. Louis drinks a bit, Louis blinks a bit. Louis makes a connection. That's the thing that you feel. We lose things, and then we choose things. And there are Louis, and there are Georges. And George, but George has George, and I need someone, Louis. Everybody loves Louis, him as well as his case. Everybody loves Louis, me included, George. Not afraid to be gooey. Louis sells what he makes. Everybody gets along with him. That's the trouble, nothing's wrong with him. Louis has to make his way, George can only make his. Louis it is!
Yes. Okay. I did not even realize that we were talking about bread, and then
I know, right? Isn't that funny? It's all about the bread. Also, I saw some people were asking for the grandma's nuggets recipe. You can check my story after this. I'll post it. I don't know if I'm allowed to. It might be a family secret, but I might do it anyway.
We might have to take a break from broadcasting, you guys. I kind of want this recipe.
We'll be there for 24 hours. So
incredible. So I don't know. Tell us some more about you. What is something like, what's a fun fact about you, or why did you choose Webco, or
why did you fun fact
musical theater thing?
Well, oh man, so many things to choose from. I'll do a fun fact because I was supposed to send it in, but I didn't because I wasn't checking my phone. Whoops. But I picked my own name. My name is Madeline. Like, that's my name. But when I was born, I was just Maddie. Until I started watching the little Madeline, like the little French girl TV show, when I was like one or two. And after I started watching that, I refused to respond to anything other than Madeline. And so my parents just had to sort of change my name because Maddie wasn't my name anymore.
That is awesome.
That's awesome. I also, I don't know, people who were at school when I was a freshman will remember that when Dottie called my name at the auditorium and like was like, the new freshman, Madeline Purches, I stood up and I went, actually, it's Madeline, like a little French girl.
Incredible. That's so good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think I ever said it wrong because everyone was like, yeah, that's Madeline, like the French girl. And I was like,
I think people think I'm really picky about it, which I guess I am, but.
That's okay. You have a right to be picky about it. It's your name. It's you.
It's true. It is my name. It's true. And I like it. I did pick it.
Amazing. Awesome. Well, hey, thanks for sharing this with us. It was really good to see you.
No problem. Good to see you too. Have a great rest of your night. I'm excited to see the rest.
Yeah. Bye. Oh, so fun. Yeah, I do. I remember like when... So let's see, Madeline was junior when I was a freshman. And I remember like getting to know the classes and stuff and people are like, oh yeah, her name's pronounced Madeline, like the French girl. Like that was always the sentence that followed it up, which is pretty funny. Okay, next up is Eden Eernissee. And Eden's fun fact that she sent in, I am very impressed by and I'm gonna wanna know more. She has never played a video game. I'm not into video games, but I play them. And so I'm curious, I have played them and I feel like a lot of people have. So I'm curious to see how she's gotten away with that. But this is Eden. She's going to be joining us to do some singing. Hey, Hey.
Hi, Lauren. I love your little preamble. Thank you.
Oh, okay. How have you not played a video game?
Okay. So probably my class would know this about me, and anyone who really knows me well. I just grew up watching like only PBS and Little House on the Prairie. I like never watched cartoons or the Disney Channel, and I feel like gaming sort of fit in that world. So I feel like it's not that surprising if you know me, but it is pretty odd. Although I'm kind of thinking like maybe quarantine is the time to like jump in, you know?
Yeah,
like,
get yourself a Nintendo Switch, start doing that Animal Crossing thing.
100%, 100%. Yay. Okay.
So, where are you originally from? Where are you now? What's quarantine been like? All of those things.
Yes. First of all, thank you, Lauren, for hosting. And also, shout out to Philip and John. Thank you so much for organizing this. We couldn't do it without you. So I'm originally from Seattle, Washington, which is where I am now. I've lived in New York for the past 5 years, just auditioning, acting, doing gigs, etc. I was doing a show in Wisconsin at the Fireside Theater right when all this happened. And so my options were to return to my empty, sad apartment or come here with my family. And so I was like, I'm just gonna come here. This seems better. So I think it was the right move. But all my love to New York, I would miss it so much. So yeah. Oh, I'm so sorry, Philip and Josh. I'm sorry, Josh. I totally slipped the tongue. My bad. Love you, Josh. Sorry, thank you.
Awesome. Well, yeah, I had the choice. I was living in New York at the time when things kind of started to go down, and I was like, I would rather be home, you know.
Totally.
And it's, you know, for a lot of people, it's your safe spot.
It's a blessing for sure. Really lucky.
That's awesome. Awesome. What are you going to be singing for us?
I am going to be singing in my own little corner, and I'm just going to take a quick second to set up. So.
Oh, yeah. Incredible.
I miss my old sweet as a mouse. When I hear a command, I obey. But I know a spot in my house where no one can stand in my way. In my own little corner, in my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be. On the wings of my fancy, I can fly anywhere. And the world will open its arms to me. I'm a young Norwegian princess or a milkmaid. I'm the greatest prima donna in the land. I'm an heiress who has always had her silk made by her own flock of silkworms in Japan. I'm a girl and a man. I can play with a cruel and confident kind of air. But I'm glad to be back in my own little corner, all alone in my own little chair. I can be whatever I want to be. I'm a thief in Calcutta, I'm a queen in Peru, I'm a mermaid dancing upon the sea. I'm a huntress on an African safari. It's a dangerous type of sport, and yet it's fun. In the night I sally forth to seek my quarry, and I find I forgot to bring my gun. I am lost in the jungle all alone and unarmed when I meet a lioness in Berlin.
Yay!
Thank you.
That was awesome. I saw someone comment and they were like, when Kat says you need props for your AB scene, but all you have is Clorox wipes. So good.
Such a little throwback for Webco, you know? The props. You gotta add them. You always gotta add your props.
Gotta have
you always have like a full suitcase. Like if you don't have like a full laundry bag of props, I don't think you're acting, right?
If you don't have a laundry bag and at least 12 shirts to fold, you're doing it wrong.
For sure.
That was awesome.
Oh, thanks, Lauren. So fun. This is awesome.
This is super fun. So I follow you on my personal account on Instagram, and I've seen your like Instagram live videos for kids. You do like a dance every day, a dance party thing. What is that? Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah. So I grew up in a modern dance company and dancing in it, which is sort of funny because I would sort of consider myself more actor singer, but I dance as well. I decided during quarantine to offer like creative movement modern classes for kids via Instagram Live because I work a lot with kids in the city and I know a lot of families are just like itching for something to do with their kids right now, and so I thought it would be sort of a good opportunity to do that. So it's been pretty fun, and I have a lot of private students now that I teach over Zoom, which has been great. It's amazing how fast these kids are learning, considering that it's all virtual. So it's kind of incredible. I mean, this sort of medium is really similar. Like, it's really impressive that you can bring people together with it, you know?
So that's awesome. That's really, really cool.
Thanks, Lauren. And thanks for following. I'm following you too.
Amazing. All the Webco love.
Also, I have to give a quick shout out. Next year, I think it is 8 kids from Seattle who are all coming to Webster acting, directing, and musical theater, which is sort of unheard of. So, yay, Seattle, Webco, you got some Seattle West Coast representing. So,
yeah. That's how I felt with like Cincinnati for a hot minute, because there were 2 people from Cincinnati when I got there, and it was me, and then I think there's one person who's a year younger than me.
That's
from Cincy, so yeah.
That's awesome. Thank you, Lauren. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks for joining us. Bye. Bye. I love that song, and I love that show so much. I saw it when it was, I saw the touring production of Cinderella. What year did I see that? Maybe like, honestly, it was a while ago, maybe like 2014, 2015, I'm not sure. But it was just magical, absolutely magical. And I have always been a big fan of like ball gowns and waltzes and like the being a princess and feeling grand and all of those things. And so Cinderella is just a really beautiful show. And I also love that it's that like gorgeous, legit singing style. That's really where my heart is. Okay, so our next person to join us is going to be Michael Dewar. And let's see, let me pull him up. Sorry guys, bear with me. Okay, so he should be joining here shortly, and then I'll pull up his little page. Hey,
hello.
How's it going?
Hold on, I'm gonna turn it around.
Who is it you have with you?
And behind the camera is Miss Bailey Jordan Reeves.
Hey,
yes.
Yep, no, we're gonna give you a shout out. Yeah, Bailey and I are best friends, and I was actually her angel in school.
Aww,
and we've stuck together ever since. Sis.
Oh, love
that
it.
That is so sweet. Yeah. Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
Okay, so what are you singing? Why did you choose this piece? Oh, well, first, let me ask you where you are. Sorry.
Currently in the beautiful mountains of Colorado Springs, Colorado, living my mountain boy life. And I'm going to be singing For Forever from Dear Evan Hansen. Awesome. And I chose this song because I love to sing it. And I haven't sung it in a while. So I thought I would today.
That's awesome. Well, whenever you're ready, we're ready to hear it.
Good. Okay. End of May or early June, this picture perfect afternoon we share. Drive the winding country road, grab a scoop at Alamode, and then we're there. An open field that's framed with trees, we pick a spot and shoot the breeze like buddies do. Quoting songs by our favorite bands, telling jokes no one understands except us two. And we talk and take in the view. All we see is sky for forever. Let the world pass by for forever. Feels like we could go on for forever this way. Two friends on a perfect day. Walk a while and talk about the things we'll do when we get out of school. Bike the Appalachian Trail, or write a book, or learn to sail. Wouldn't that be cool? There's nothing that we can't discuss, like girls we wish would notice us, but never do. She looks around and says to me, there's nowhere else I'd rather be. And I say, me too. And we talk and take in the view. We just talk and take in the view. All we see is sky for forever. Let the world pass by for forever. Feels like we could go on for forever. This way, this way. All we see is light for forever, cause the sun shines bright for forever, like we'll be alright for forever this way. Two friends on a perfect day. Mary goes racing toward the tallest tree. From far across a yellow field, I hear him calling, follow me. There we go, wondering how the world might look from up so high, one foot after the other, one branch then to another. I climb higher and higher, I climb till the entire sun shines on my face. And I suddenly feel the branch give way. I'm on the ground. My arm goes numb. I look around and I see him come to get me. He's come to get me. And everything's okay. All we see is sky for forever. The world pass by for forever. Buddy, you and I for forever this way, this way. All we see is light, cause the sun burns bright. We could be alright for forever this way.
Oh my gosh. First First of all, why was my camera facing
I'm
the other
crying.
But otherwise, I'm crying. So remove my makeup, okay? That was awesome. That was really beautiful. I can see why you love to sing that song. It's
so fun.
Yeah. Fun? I don't know if it's fun, but it's like, you know, it's fun to sing for sure.
Go through your 1, 2, 3, 4, do your beats, you know. The Larry Cheater way.
Yes. That was awesome.
Thanks.
Okay. Well, thanks so much. That was wonderful. Is there anything else you want to share with us? Do you have any shout outs or any fun facts or anything?
This is your time. I guess broken record, but shout out to the class of 2015. It's our 5-year anniversary.
Oh, yay!
You've seen all of us. Everyone watching. You've seen the entire musical theater class of 2015. I hope you feel special. Yeah. So thank you. You're awesome. You're so funny. I love you.
Stop it. Amazing. Well, thanks so much. This was a lot of fun. I hope you enjoy the rest of our show.
Bye, everybody.
All right. So, while I have you all here, we are going to take a brief intermission. It's literally going to be 2 seconds. Instagram only lets you live stream for a certain amount of time. So in order to make sure that we don't go over our limit and like miss out on people, I'm going to end the stream right now. And then I'm going to start it again, right at, like super, super fast. So all you have to do is stay right where you are and you will see another notification or you will see on the page that there is another live stream. Click it, go to it, and we will get started on the second half of our performances, and we hope to see you all there. Bye. Hey guys, we're back. We're back with part 2 of the Alumni Lockdown Cabaret. Did you see that hand motion? That was very, well, it wasn't very fussy, but it made me feel very fussy. P.S. A great quarantine watch is Fosse Verdon. Oh my gosh. So good. Just so good. I am like the biggest Fosse fan. I'm not at all a dancer, but oh man, if I could dance like Fosse, if I could do his work justice, that would be all. That I would devote my career to that. Ugh, so good. Such good stuff. Ugh, I know, Fosse. Okay, looks like everybody's rolling back in. This is awesome. This is so fun. Yay. While we're waiting, so our next guest... three of them were acting majors and two of them were MTs. So we too were a very small class. We were a class of total of 15, but there were only 5 women, and I'm sure she'll introduce to us as well. Oh, it says she's unable to join. Vivienne, try joining it again. This is her little bio. Follow her on Instagram, do all that stuff. She and her boyfriend, Jeremy, who's actually going to be playing with her this evening, have been doing a really cool cabaret of their own called Two Scoops. And I believe it's every Friday. I could be totally wrong on that. But check out her page and check out their page, Two Scoops. It's got their cabarets on it. And it's been a lot of fun to see those. Let's see if I can do it from my end. Oh, here we go. I think I can do it from my end. So I think I'm adding Vivienne. Let's see. Oh, there she is.
Hi.
Yay. Hey.
Oh my gosh. Hi.
How's life? How's everything going?
It's going really well. How are you?
I'm good. So where are you? Who's with you? What are you doing? How's life?
So many questions. It's going super well. I'm in Mount Shasta, California, actually, right now with my parents and my boyfriend. This is Jeremy Jacobs. For any of you that don't know who Jeremy Jacobs is, he is going to be a senior at Webster in musical direction for musical theater. And we have been doing Two Scoops. It's Friday at 5, and we do musical theater songs and piano
five
songs.
5 Pacific time.
5 o'clock yeah. here in California.
Yeah.
So that's what we're doing. We're just kind of hanging out. We're in quarantine, trying to make the most of it. But we're, like, super, super excited to be here singing, and it's super fun to see Lauren because we just don't get to see each other because of quarantine right now. But, yeah, so we're really excited to be a part of this. It's very fun. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay. What are you singing?
I am singing I Get a Kick Out of You, and Jeremy's going to accompany me.
Awesome. You're always a big fan of the classics, and I love it.
I love them. Yes.
Yeah. They're our faves. Okay.
Well, here we go.
Whenever you're ready.
My story is much too sad to be told. Totally cold. The only exception I know is the case when I'm out on a quiet spree, fighting vainly the old ennui, and I suddenly turn and see your fabulous face. I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. But tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some get a kick from cocaine. I'm sure that if I took even one sniff, that would bore me terrifically too. But I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time I see you're standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously don't adore me. I get no kick in a plane. Flying too high with some guy in the sky is my ideal of do. Yet I get a kick out of you.
That was fun. I was just about to start clapping, and then you guys looked at each other and said, "That was fun." So sweet. That was awesome. That was so fun.
Hey, thanks.
Thank you.
So, I don't know. Tell me, I feel like it's hard for me to ask you questions about yourself because I feel like I know so much about you.
We've been together
for the last 4 years. Yes.
I thought of a great fun fact. So Jeff Awada, was doing the 100-mile swim club at Webster. And, I saw him at the pool one day because I also did laps at the pool freshman year. And he was like, well, what lap or what mile are you on? And I had no idea what he's talking about. And so I joined and I actually did 100 miles. I finished senior year. So yes, Jeff Wada and I are in the 100-mile club at Webster. Go Gorlocks.
Yes, the 100-mile swim club.
Yes.
Isn't there like, there's like a board and you like put your name on it too?
Yeah, and you put like the tack marks, and I kept seeing that he was getting farther and farther away from me. And then sophomore year, it didn't happen at all. And then I had to pick it back up because it just wasn't going so well.
Oh my God. That's awesome.
But yes. Yeah, that was my fun fact. I had to think of one. But
that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, what are you, so you can't, I mean, you probably can't swim now, right? So what are you doing instead? No. Are you doing anything instead?
Yes, I've been running. We actually go on family runs, my entire family and dog, and we make Jeremy come with us. Yeah. And we go on runs, but my dad usually just goes way ahead of all of us and then loops around to, like, cheer us on. But, yes, we've been going on lots of Luthin family runs lately.
That's hilarious. Jeremy, yeah. Do you like to run, or are you just along for the ride?
No, I do like running. I'm really just along for the ride, though.
Like chat pace, though.
Yeah, I like talking. I don't like just, like, running to run. I really
That's
like
how
chat.
I am, too. Yeah. I'm like, what am I running from? I don't want to – what?
Yeah.
This
yeah.
hurts my knees. I don't want to do it anymore. Unless I'm running from an animal that's going to eat me, I'm done.
Yes.
Yeah. That's awesome. Well, thanks for joining us, guys. Did you have to say any other shout-outs?
No, I just wanted to say our other favorite pastime is looking at your cooking show on your Instagram.
Yes.
It's amazing.
Wow. I feel so honored. Incredible. Yeah, so I'm definitely one of those people that's been baking a lot during quarantine.
It's awesome.
Instead of going on runs, I've been baking a lot of sweets and eating them.
That's a great way to go, too.
It's an option.
But thank you so much for doing this and for everyone that set this up. And we're just super excited to be part of this. And I love being a Gorlock.
Go Gorlocks!
Jeremy does too. So we're really happy to be here doing the Gorlock thing. So it's really wonderful.
Love you.
Love you too. See you soon.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Bye.
So, fun. So yeah, what Vivienne said, it's okay. I guess it's a cooking show, but on my personal Instagram account, which is at Lauren Luhu, I have I've just been baking things and I post like the recipes and stuff as I'm going along step by step. And I posted one the other day, I was making scones and blueberry jam and lemon curd. And it was so funny. I posted a picture of myself that evening and I was like, making scones tonight with blueberry jam and lemon curd. And multiple people responded to the thing and were like, oh my God, we're so excited for this. I can't wait to see this recipe. And I was like, oh, I guess I made a thing. So, but it's been really fun. I've certainly not been running and I really should be, but maybe one day. All right. So next up is Caitlin Witty. Caitlin Witty is another of my fabulous classmates who graduated with me. She was a MT, so an MT of 2019, one of the other of the five women, the two female MTs too of that year. She's a powerhouse of a lady. She's incredibly talented and gifted and kind and grounded. Hey!
Hey! How's it going?
How are you? It's going. Good. What's new? So where are you? Where are you at home or are you elsewhere? What's going on?
I'm home. I'm in Connecticut with my family and my dogs. I have my mom here with me today. She's going to press play.
Yes. We love a good stage mom moment.
Yes.
Doing this has, I don't know about you, but it's kind of felt to me a little bit like doing auditions to get into colleges where you know if you're singing you gotta put your song on a CD or on a whatever and you bring in your little thing and then you press play and it feels a little bit like that.
Oh my gosh, yeah, it's very strange, but I mean it's so nice to be on here with everybody. This is the closest to normal performance it feels like.
Yeah, totally. Awesome. Yeah. Well, what are you gonna sing for us and why?
I'm going to sing The Life I Never Led. I was going to play Sister Mary Robert this summer with Arrow Rock, and I'll do it next summer, and so now I'm so excited to get to perform it for some people, because I love this song.
Awesome. Whenever you're ready.
Awesome. Thank you. I've never talked back. I've never slept late. I've never sat down when told to stand straight. I've never let go and gone with the flow. Don't even know really well. I've never asked questions or taken a dare. I've never worn clothes that might make people stare. I've never rebelled or stood up and yelled or even just held my head high. And all of the feelings unspoken, all of the truth unsaid, they're all I have left of the life I never had. I've never gone surfing or ran with a crowd or danced on a table or laughed much too loud. I've never quite dared to leave myself bare. I've just been too scared I might fall. I've never seen Paris swung naked and kissed. I've never quite realized just how much I've missed. And what did I get for hatching each bed? Another regret, and that's all. And all of the wishes unasked for. I want to be brave. I want to be strong. I want to believe I'm where I belong. To stand up and say, I'm seizing the day. To not just obey, but to choose. And I may not serve, I may not see France, but I have to know I still have a chance. And maybe I'll make a painful mistake that's mine to take or refuse. And all of the doors yet to open, all of the rooms ahead, they're beckoning bright, scary and new. But I'm standing tall, and I'm marching through. What's God made me?
That was awesome. That was really awesome.
Thank you.
Thanks. I never get tired of hearing this sing.
Oh, thank you. It's so good to be on here. Everybody is so amazing. And the support in the Webco community is just amazing to see and be part of.
Yeah, it is. It really is. Yeah. So you're going to get the chance to play that next summer?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Arrow Rock was able to move their season. They're such an incredible theater.
That's awesome. That's awesome. That's amazing. Okay. Well, any other shout outs? Any other? You didn't send in a fun fact. What's your fun fact?
Oh, well, I can open.
Oh, wait, you did.
I can open doorknobs with my feet. And it's very helpful if you're carrying a lot of things. It's something that my mom did. And I didn't realize it's like a normal thing to do, but I've realized as I've grown and have done it, and people have been like, what is that? And so now I know it's a special skill, and it's very helpful. So I would, you know, encourage you all to try to open a doorknob with your feet, because then you don't have to put the things down that you're carrying if you're barefoot.
That's hilarious. Okay, when you said that, I originally was picturing you like laying on your back, you know, with your feet up in the air and opening a doorknob. And I was like, that's kind of weird. Why would you ever do that? But you're actually like standing and walking towards a door and you open the doorknob with your foot.
Yes, I can grab the doorknob with my foot and open it. Yes.
Oh my God. Is that on your resume? Is that a special skill on your resume?
It is on my resume.
That's so good. That is so good. Oh, I love it. Well, next cabaret, I feel like we need a foot moment. So,
all right.
We'll just pencil. Everyone that's planning the next cabaret will pencil it. Yes. Yeah. I did a foot peel the other day. So, but hey, we're in quarantine. So it's not like I see anyone.
True. Except for now.
Yes. Except for now, which is great. Well, thanks so much for sharing that with us. That was awesome. I love you.
Awesome. Love you too, Lauren. Bye.
Bye. Amazing. I know I said it. I was like, I absolutely love hearing Caitlin sing, and I never get tired of it. That's one really great gift about being at Webco and having the same, you know, 15 classmates for all 4 years, is you really get to know these people and love these people and grow with these people. And yeah, I mean, all 15 of my classmates are my best friends in the entire world. And it's just, it's a real treat to get to train and learn and grow in such a close experience. So next is Ben Rosebery. He is an MT from 2003. And last year, after my senior showcase, 2019 senior showcase, he actually sang at the Cabaret at 54 Below there. And I was telling him earlier, I remember he sang an original piece that just like blew me away. And I was instantly on YouTube afterward looking him up. Super talented and really wonderful guy. And he's going to join us and sing us a song. And it's going to be great. Hey.
How's it going?
Pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Awesome. Hey, everyone.
So where are you quarantining from? Is where are you from originally? Are those the same places, different, et cetera?
Same place. So I was born in New York City, born in Brooklyn, and I am quarantining in Inwood, so the other side of the island, basically, just the north tip of Manhattan. Yeah, it's been great. I mean, you know, it's been what it is. Manhattan is a danger zone, but we're okay.
Good. Well, I'm glad. Yeah. Are you quarantining with anyone, or are you just in your own apartment by yourself? Or
I'm in my apartment with my wife and our cat, and it's been. I mean, it's honestly like we're a family. We're very close, and you know, we always life just gets a little crazy, and we always kind of are trying to catch up. And so this has been an opportunity for us to just kind of catch up and spend time together. It's been that part of it has been really nice.
Yeah, I definitely feel that. It's been such a treat to be home with my parents and like get to just spend time with them, you know, because I feel like a lot of times we're always going from one thing to the next, to the next, to the next, especially as artists, we are going from one place to the next, to the next. And it's really been a treat definitely to slow down and kind of have to breathe for a minute.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Well, what are you going to be singing for us?
Well, so this is a classic. It's called For All We Know, but this is the sort of an homage to the Donny Hathaway version. The song speaks to me. It's spoken to me for years. I actually sang it on the Apollo stage back in like 2004. It had been a dream of mine. And it's just his rendition of it is, to me, it speaks to, I think, what we're all kind of going through right now. So here we go.
Awesome. Thank you.
For all we know, we may never meet again. We won't say goodnight until the last minute I'll hold out my hand, yes, and my heart will be in it. For all we know, this may only be a dream. We come and we go like the ripples of a stream. So love me tonight. Tomorrow may never come. For all we know, for all we know.
Bravo. That was awesome.
Thanks.
Really beautiful. So I was very intrigued by your fun fact. Can you tell us more?
Sure. I mean, I was a kid that grew up in New York City, and I used to ride the subway, and I would purposefully ride in the front car. And this was back when the driver's booth was literally just a little booth. It was not the full front of the car, if you've been in New York City lately. So I would purposefully ride where I could see out of the front door and pretend I was driving the train. But I was also very, very attached to, especially those, I'm sure we've all been on the subway when those conductors with personality get on and they're like, you know, next stop, 125th Street. And I, as a kid, thought it was like the coolest thing ever. So, but I always thought that that was just one job. And I was like, this is my dream job. If I can drive a train, because kids think trains are cool, but also get to be the guy that makes those cool announcements, then like my life is set. And then I found out that it's two different people, and I was like, no, I'm gonna pursue something else.
No. That's so tragic.
Yeah. No, it's not tragic. It's all good.
That's awesome though. Yeah. I love when I would get on the train. I just moved to New York in December, and unfortunately, you know, left in mid-March, but it was super fun to get on the one train on the way to work, and all of a sudden you get the really cool guy or gal who's like, all right, folks, next stop, 112th Street, doors closing. You know, it's so much more fun.
Yeah, I love the ones that are like purposefully doing like transatlantic. All of my Webster folks, we all know what transatlantic is, you know, like next stop, 112, you know, it's like old school, like radio broadcast, like incredible. So yeah.
So good. Awesome. Well, thanks so much for joining us. Do you have any shout outs before I let you go?
I see so many people that I know on this, and I just want to say, like, I'm such a huge, I owe so much of my career to Webster, and I'm so grateful to all of you. And it's so strange that I've made connections over the years since 2003 with graduating classes, and that doesn't surprise me at all. You know, it really is. I think we're a family, and we really just need to like keep embracing that. So yeah, just shout out to all of y'all.
Well, it's been so nice to meet you and to get to do this with you and to share this with you. So
yeah, a real pleasure. Thank you.
See ya.
Bye.
All right, everyone. Well, that leaves the last song of the evening. And I'm going to sing it, and it's going to be fun. Before I do, though, I just want to say that, kind of echoing what everyone else has said, Webster has been one of the best things in my life and one of the most supportive groups of people in my life. I'm really lucky to have been blessed with an amazing, supportive, loving family, and I have also been blessed with an amazing, supporting, loving theater family and college family. They've done so much for me. They've been there in literally my worst times and most of my best. And it's been such a joy to have that connection in the world. All right, so I'm gonna back up. I'm literally kneeling in front of my camera right now. So this is my friend Tommy.
Hi. You guys are so talented. I've been listening on the other side of the room all this time, and y'all are very talented. So
he's like been mouthing to me across the way, like, that's so good, or like, oh my god, and I'm like, yeah, I know, we're pretty amazing. So Tommy is a friend of mine. He is an amateur musical therapist and an incredibly talented musician and singer. It's true. And so when the blast went out that was like, hey, any alum want to do this, I immediately was like, yes, I would like to host, please. and then I was like, you know what? I kind of want to sing too. And if you guys know me at all, I am not the type of person that normally sings when I perform. I don't know why at some point in my like middle school, high school years, I guess, I kind of got it in my brain that I wasn't a musical theater singer, that because I didn't have a belt or a vibrato, that I wasn't like good enough for it. And so it's just been kind of something that I've been dealing with since then, trying to break down that little wall. And so so it's really exciting for me to perform. It's also really scary, but it'll be fine. And I know you guys were there to support me, so yeah. Anyway, so I'm quarantined in Cincinnati, Ohio, which I think I said earlier, with my parents and our three weenie dogs, which is just as crazy as it sounds. It's been a really great time to get to really spend time and be with my family. And one of the things that I noticed in the last several weeks is that I have been hugely, like, one of the biggest sense memories for me with regard to my dad is music. My dad has amazing taste in music. And when I was young, he and I would like listen to all of his CDs on stereo, and he's got everything from like classical music and opera to like rock and to Broadway and to Celtic singing. And one of my favorite things to do with him is just listen to music and see what comes on. And he and I even went on a drive the other day in the convertible together, and we were just shuffling through his playlist, and it makes my heart really happy to listen to music with him. So I've been putting together a playlist for myself of songs that make me think of my dad and that make me feel close to him. And a lot of, like, 80% of this playlist is John Prine or James Taylor. So I chose the song from that playlist. I'm going to be singing Fire and Rain by James Taylor. Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. You just gotta see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. And I won't make it any other way. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines and pieces on the ground. Whoa, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Thank you. Awesome. That was fun. Yay. Well, thank you guys for joining us. Round of applause to all of the performers tonight. It has been so cool and so fun to have done this. It's really been awesome. And thank you so much to the current students for organizing this. John and Philip and Josh, thank you so much. You guys have no idea how helpful they were throughout this whole thing and how much coordination this took to put together. So you guys should be really proud of what you've been able to accomplish. And this has been awesome. And I keep getting asked for a Bucky cameo. And while I can't do a Bucky cameo because he's upset and upstairs, very scared of the storm, I will give you an Olive cameo. This is my dog, Olive. She's a little weenie dog. She's a sleepy little weenie dog right now. She's tired. She's an
Instagram model.
She is an Instagram model. If you want to follow her Instagram, it's at Olive Lou. What is it? Olive the Doxy Pup. Olive the Doxy Pup. You can also follow me on my Instagram. Oh my gosh. My mom brought Bucky down. Hold on. Oh, this is the boy. This is the icon, Bucky. This is Bucky. Bucky is an honorary class member of 2019. So yeah, Bucky and Olive. Yay. Okay, well, enough of me showing you my weenie. I just had to squeeze that in there somewhere. This has been so much fun. Thank you so much for the opportunity, guys. And I love you, Webco. Bye. Much love.